To update or not to update? That is the question.
iOS 14 is almost upon us, and we've gathered everything you need to know to decide whether an update should be high priority or put off until later. This is DIY in 5. Everyone, I'm Trisha Hirschberger. Welcome to DIY in 5, the show where we make tech easily digestible in 5 minutes or less, usually. Today we're talking all about iOS 14, the new operating system update coming to iPhones this fall. What are the new features, and is it worth the update? Let's dig in. If you find the tips in today's video useful, be sure to like this video, subscribe to this channel, and tap that bell so that you don't miss out on any future tech tips. Let's start off with a feature long beloved to Android users and finally coming to iOS, widgets. Widgets are a bit of self-contained code that allows a small bit of an app to be displayed without fully opening the app. And now they are available on the home screen with this latest iOS update. Certain apps will have widget support, mostly Apple proprietary apps at first, with different sizes available you can choose from and then pin onto your home screen. Note, you cannot manually resize these widgets nor pin them to the middle of a page, but it's a start. You can even add a Smart Stack widget, which allows you to stack multiple widgets on top of each other, occupying the same home screen real estate, but showing multiple widgets worth of information with just a swipe. Pretty cool. There's also a new app library interface at the end of your home screens to show all your apps at a glance in neat little Apple auto-organized drawers. No longer do you have to put your infrequently used apps in the folder of shame at the end of your last homepage. Now, you can hide apps from a home screen altogether and they will appear in your app library instead. It's not only great for cleaning up your home screen, it's also great if you have apps on your phone you'd rather others not find out about. I swear I totally deleted TFT and Hearthstone off my phone. Speaking of cleaning up the look of your home screen, Apple has incorporated other space-saving measures as well. Incoming phone calls and FaceTime requests will no longer take up the whole screen, only displaying a bar at the top. From this bar, you can choose to take the call, reject the call, or continue working underneath.
Not today, Aunt Kathy.
Siri will also now take up less space, showing a small animated icon at the bottom of the screen and giving you results in a small bar at the top of the screen. While this animation takes up less screen real estate, you should note that you are not able to continue working underneath Siri without exiting Siri altogether. So, mega multitaskers, be forewarned. Another way Apple is saving some space is with a new picture-in-picture mode. Now, FaceTime calls or videos can be run in a small window so you can continue working in another app at the same time. These small picture-in-picture windows can be resized, moved around, and even totally swiped off-screen so that you hear audio only. It remains to be seen if this will entirely decimate YouTube's paid user base. App clips allow users to use some app features without downloading the entire app. Great for buying a coffee, filling a meter, making a reservation, you get the idea. All by just scanning a code similar to Android Instant apps. This is great. I literally have several parking meter apps installed on my phone that I only ever used once. A new accessibility feature that could be quite useful is sound recognition. Your phone will listen for certain sounds that you choose, like sirens or alarms, in your accessibility settings, and alert you on screen if detected. Not only is this great for hearing impaired users, but if you like to jog while listening to music, this could be very useful too. Some other welcome additions include that you can now change your default email and browser apps. Gmail and Chrome users rejoice. You can also search for emoji within the native keyboard while you type. Happy face, prayer hands. For the privacy-minded folks out there, Apple will now notify you by way of a small green or orange dot at the top of the screen if an app is accessing your camera or microphone, respectively. And finally, Apple has added a new way to further customize shortcuts with a back tap feature. You can now double tap or triple tap the back of the phone to access custom shortcuts of your choosing, like taking a screenshot or bringing up Siri. Cool. So, should you update? If you are a mega multitasker or someone who's very particular about the layout of your home screen, then I would say this latest iOS update might be a game changer for you. If you found yourself giving a resounding meh to most of the features mentioned in this video, then maybe it's best to hold off for a bit. What new feature has you most excited? Let us know in the comments. All right, everyone, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time with more DIY in 5.